So this I've just finished this, and it's a poem. I'm Edmund Tavall, and you're in my studio in West Norwood, in deepest South London, and that's where we are today. For everyone, this year has been just the most extraordinary, exploratory, complicated, dreadful, and bizarrely creative time. And one of the things that's been so profoundly painful and difficult, of course, is that everything has been about separation. Everything has been about keeping away from other people, not passing things on. And my life as a maker of things has always been about making something and passing it on. We are re-energized and reinvented through touch, and that's gone away. So the things that I've been making have all been about touch. So that when we come out of this extraordinary, painful time, there will be things again to hold and pass on. I've made two new bodies of work, both of which use wonderful particular materials. One is English alabaster. This is the most gorgeous stuff possible. This is the material that throughout the Middle Ages was turned into the most incredible Gothic sculpture. It's one of the great materials of England. And it's just beautiful, lambent, translucent material. And so I've been using this Nottingham alabaster with gold and porcelain and making these places, these very still installations, which reflect on being here now. And that is this moment. What a vitrine does is to actually pause the whole world. It's sort of, you're taking that bit of air and just holding it. And I've called the whole project Tasset, which is the musical notation of pausing. I think the first thing to say about this forced pause is that you have to be incredibly straightforward about the privilege that some artists, like me, have had of being able to work uninterrupted. So this one, for instance, took me 3 months, and it's got so many layers here. And actually, the sort of velocity of the world was so slow that I could just come back again and again and again and again and again. So these are really, this is slow art. I really do not want to valorize any of this, because people have been going through horror. For many people, the isolation of this closing down of conversation, of connection to the world is an ongoing pain. And that's tough, really tough, and it's something that is going to take years to repair and rebuild. Yeah, I'm talking about privilege. I've been locked down with these incredibly beautiful Chinese bowls. Almost 1,000 years old, beautiful bowl, but broken and then mended in the 17th century with gold. So this is a gold mend here. Can you see that incredibly beautiful line of and mended visibly? So it's a visible mend. It's called kintsugi, and it's that idea of something which is damaged and then visibly mended, so that you say, you know, this isn't a perfect object. It's more extraordinary because it's been damaged, because it's had a life, and I'm going to show you that life. I'm going to show you the line of the break. And that's kind of what this moment is about. That bowl is immeasurably more real and connected to the world because it's been broken, and someone's noticed it's been broken and they've wanted to patch it up. And so what I've been doing is, you know, by myself in the studio, been making objects, some of which have been, you know, when they've been fired, have been sort of had cracked a little bit, and some of which have been chipped or whatever. And instead of, you know, breaking them up and throwing them away, I've been mending them and patching them. And that absolute, this is that absolutely about now. You know, don't pretend that you can go back to what it was like before.